I'm gonna do the little thing first. I have 3 dozen eggs. I know that's the announcement you're waiting to hear from me. I have 3 dozen eggs, so if you're looking to get some baking done or have some farm fresh eggs, see me over at the table. Now you wanna do the big one?
No, do the Halloween one.
Okay, you do the Halloween.
I'll do the Halloween.
Okay, so update on the Halloween party. So just as a reminder, Saturday, October 29th is our costume Halloween party here in the Fellowship Hall. We are going to have another planning session this week. We are very, very close to having everything finalized. By the end of the week, I will be sending out an email of anything left that I need. I'm in pretty good shape from decoration standpoint. I think we're in pretty good shape for food. We still might need a few other baked goods. So we'll have a list by the end of the week. The only thing I really would like, so we have this gorgeous coffin that was donated by... Yashu.
We should qualify. This is a paper cardboard.
It's a cardboard coffin, but it looks really cool. Anyways, as part of the decoration, does anybody have a full size plastic skeleton that we could borrow? If you have one, that would be awesome.
Let's verify plastic. We're not looking.
I don't need Cousin Len. I just need plastic fake
skeleton.
So if anybody has one, let me know. So all right, thank you.
All right, okay. So we had a great time yesterday.
Who came? Who was here? Raise your hand. Who was here last night? Okay.
All right. Yeah. Or during the day.
During the day.
We had about 220 admissions. Our estimated profit is $4,047, which is only $20 higher than the next closest year.
But it is a record year.
It is a record year by $20.
$20.
We are happy to see some old friends and make new friends. We are especially happy to see Denise Harmon and her family. I don't know if you remember, we had her on our prayer list last year. She had had several strokes, and she has a cancer diagnosis. Things still look pretty grim for her, but she donated a couple baskets. I said, oh, it'll be great to see you on Saturday. She's like, yeah, I'm going to come during the day. And I said, oh, well, you can watch the live stream. And she said, oh, no, I'm coming. I'm coming tonight. I'm coming.
We had a lot of first-timers again, too, so that was great as well.
Yep. And I am excited to report that Joe Andriana won his first basket.
Ever.
All he had to do was go to Rhode Island and ignore us, and that was it. So, and we always love our grand prize winner. It's always a special treat. And we really like it when it's somebody from the church family. And this year, if you weren't there and you didn't see, it was Charlie Widner. So Charlie and Shelby are excited beyond belief about that. So and we have video from one of Charlie's friends that we're going to be posting. And we can't do this alone. So thank you to everybody who came, all of our support team members. So we have everybody who wrapped baskets and prepared the hall, took care of the food. Joyce and her team was amazing. Thank you. And everybody who worked the event, you did a great job. And thank you to everybody who pulled me off the ledge when I was going a little crazy. So, including you.
Did we wear out Joyce? Because I don't see her today.
I think we wore her out.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. But thank you all.
Thank you.
Jim.
I haven't been up in a while, but just a friendly reminder, this time last year I put out an offer. The offer still stands. I enjoy playing with my cameras and my lights and everything, so if the fall is a beautiful time to do family portraits, get ready for portraits for Christmas cards, that kind of thing. So if anybody wants that payment, it's just simply, if you think I did a good job, it's a donation back to the church. That's all I'm asking. I think my last victims were Faith and Bob. At one point, I went over to their house. During prom season, I did a bunch of prom photos. And they were friends of mine, so I gave them the same criteria. And I'm hoping that there were checks that came to the church. Yep. So there are a number of families that donated back to the church based on that. So I'm still learning how to use my lights. And, I'm trying to be good at it. But at any rate, the offer still stands. Just let me know. It's fall season, so it's sports season. It's football season. So I am doing other activities, but we can try to schedule it in. I can come to your house. We can go. Next weekend, I've got one of the folks that I did prom that asked me to come to Southford Falls to do some senior portraits next week, and it'll be sort of the same thing, donation back to the church. So it's my, as I'm learning how to do it, it's my way of giving back to the church or my time and talent to do that. So just let me know if there's interest.
Thank you. Thank you. Just as I've been blessed to be a blessing to others.
Good.
All time.
Today we have a special opportunity to hear what excitement goes on in our sister church in Seymour, Methodist Church. Cindy and Kelly is here. So, well, shall we welcome.
I'm Kelly Taylor. This is Cindy Parker. Hi. We're with your Seymour United Methodist Church, your sister church, and we are on the missions team. I am the missions coordinator and club communicator. Cindy runs our Outreach Cheers group. We are blessed to be able to expand what we do, not only to our community, but worldwide, because of our connection with an organization called Mission Central. It is a 48,000 square foot warehouse full of missions down in Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania, and we were invited to be a satellite hub. You went down for the tour, right?
I haven't.
You got to go. This place is amazing. I had a true God moment while touring this place, and God spoke to me and said, this is the work you need to be doing. We, as a church, agreed to become a satellite hub. We decided we wanted to do local ministry within our community, which is perfectly acceptable, and then we're also the collection site for all kits and cleaning buckets that are collected throughout the state of Connecticut, and we're the only hub in Connecticut right now. So we're the collection site, and we get it down to where it needs to be. We also have a very exciting missions program. We have a clothing closet in our upstairs schoolrooms for the local people in need. New to like me, new clothing. We're hoping to open again soon, now that COVID's calmed down. we're looking for help. Monday mornings between 9 and 11, we try to get together all those who can to fold and steam and sort through the clothing that we have currently. If anyone feels to come, the need to come, or feels the call to come, we would love it. We'd also love to be able to work with any of your missions projects. If you want to extend the invitation, we'll be happy to see what we can do to help out. We provide school supplies for the Seymour Education District this year. We collected 24 book bags and filled them all with supplies. We do a monthly food collection for Seymour Oxford Food Bank and Spooner House, along with providing a monthly meal. And Cindy's going to talk more about the CHEERS project.
Hi. CHEERS came about because of our new venture in missions. And we started out with, I don't know if you knew about, we did these mats out of the grocery shopping bags. You took the grocery shopping bags and you crocheted them. We had a big event to teach people how to do that. And we've done very well with that. A little hard now that there's no plastic bags, but we'll still get one here or there. We have a lady that is loves making them, so we're still making them. They're mats for the homeless to put under so they'll stay dry can use them for lots of things. So we're still doing that. If anybody has any plastic bags that they want to give up, I know they're kind of precious right now. I went to Virginia a week ago, and they still use plastic bags. And we went to a Walmart for some food, and she put stuff, one in a bag. And I'm like, I was going to say, you know, I don't need that many bags, but I thought, I'll take the plastic bags. Thank you. So I brought that, and my son saved a few. Anyway, so we started out with that, and then we decided there was a need to bring and help our community. CHEERS does mostly for the area in Connecticut. We do mostly for the homeless. We put together what's called Brian's Bags, which is we usually do like a Ziploc bag with, we take, canned meats, crackers and nuts, and we do toothbrushes and hair brushes. And we put these bags together, and we usually try to put them in a backpack, or we just did, 52, grocery bags, and the plastic handle ones that, you know, we buy now. And we filled them with those kinds of things. And also we try to do something extra each time we do something a little different. This time we're going to do those little, we bought some foil heating blankets. You know, I guess like after you've been in a fire or something, they're very lightweight, but they're supposed to be warm and they're lightweight, something easy for them to use and something they can always use. We give them a little simple medical kit, socks. We give baseball caps, sunglasses, sunblock, all depending on the season. It's all donated, and the ladies group puts that all together. We also are now helping there's a woman's shelter. What's the other? Abuse? There's two shelters there. I think there's the...
Women and children.
Yeah. We have to try that on there. There's the diaper drive we try to help out with also as we've adventured out to that. And we're looking for new ideas to bring everybody together. We'd like to make our group together. We have two of the other local churches. The ladies that come, we're a very small group. We'd love to make it bigger. We meet on Thursday, every other Thursday at 10 o'clock to 12. And we have a closet at our church that we store our things. And like I said, we're trying to adventure out. If anybody has an idea somewhere that someone needs stuff, like I said, we try to keep it more local. And we also have ladies that crochet lap blankets in the hats and scarves that we also give to wherever is needed. So we'd like you guys to join in because we're all local and just want to keep it a big family. So we'd like to see some of you ladies if you can join us.
Or
men. You know, why would anyone? And like I said, too, this closet, if you know someone that have been, you know, in need of clothes, for whatever reason, fire, low income, we do limit certain things because we tried doing it otherwise, but we had some take advantage. So we give them a certain amount that they can come, but we do it we usually do once a month.
Yeah, but if, get back to that.
If there's a need and you know somebody that needs it ASAP, we try to put stuff together and work with them. So you can come, and it's an all free organization. Okay?
It's every size, every gender, from toddlers on up to adults, men, women, teens, all exquisite clothing. Clothing you take in has no pills, no runs, no stains on it. We make sure the clothing is in pristine condition before we send it out.
Our pastor likes to iron.
Yeah.
So everything is ironed.
Yeah, and we do work ecumenically with the other churches in these tiers group, and we're just very excited about what we're able to do and provide our community with, and we want to extend that out to you as well. Anyone who wants to join in any of these endeavors, you can always contact Pastor Lisa Bosworth, and she will let Cindy and I know. And we'd be very happy to invite you into our group or join your group as needed.
Yeah. I just got one more thing. Yeah, what we call them, our Brian's Bag, are the homeless. We have a lady that started this organization that delivers directly. She goes right to where the homeless are. So that's how we dispense them. We get our things together. We call her up. We do about 3 or 4 times a year. We try to do at least 50 to 60 bags.
I think the most important thing we have to let these other people know is these projects that we work on, we all make them fun.
Yeah.
It's not a dull drudgery. It's a fun event. It's fellowship. It's friendship.
Yeah.
It's camaraderie. And it's doing God's work that He put us here for.
And we're all kind of small around here lately, so we need to get together and make ourselves even more stronger and more powerful.
More information here. Me, so...
Thank you for your time. We truly
appreciate
it.
Thank you. I hope to see some of you.
Make sure you join us for coffee hour.
I'll stay for a little bit. All who are able, please stand for the call to worship. When we are lonely and feeling lost,
Jesus follows us, brings us health and peace.
When we are angry and frustrated,
Jesus heals our problems and soothes our tempers.
When we are sorrowful and broken,
Jesus binds our wounds with His healing love.
Come, let us worship the one who cares so abundantly for us.
Amen.
Please remain standing for the opening hymn and prayer. O Lord, for the healing
of your cross to us,
for the patience you have with us,
for your presence that will never fail,
we give you thanks.
Bring our hearts and spirits to you, that we may grow in our faith and service to you by serving others. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Our opening hymn is in the Faith We Sing book. It's number 2129, I Have Decided to Follow Jesus.
Yeah. Are you a disciple? Jesus called us to be a disciple. And United Methodist Church has mission and its goal clearly put it out as our church mission is to make disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. Be a disciple if we learn from him and follow him. Following Jesus is a little bit different than we follow somebody on Facebook or internet. Be holy as I am holy, said God. Holy in Hebrew is kadosh, meaning consecrated, dedicated, and sanctified. Or sometimes it simply means cut or separate. Church in Greek is ecclesia, meaning ecclesia, people, which is people called out. Our honest evaluation, churches have failed many ways to make disciples. And that is no excuse for us. To follow Jesus, we need to let go of the world. Sometimes we say, cross the Jordan River, as a symbolic way. Being holy is a journey. It's not just one time deal once we're baptized, it's done. We cannot be holy in just one day, or by one miracle, or one by encounter. But this is most easiest thing that we can do. We don't have to be intelligent. We don't have to have money or power. It just need to follow. In fact, those who are rich in power and carrying a lot of things in themselves, they don't usually follow. It is an invitation to take journey with Jesus each and every day, every turn, every crossroad. As Paul said, I die every day in my sin, and I am a new born in Christ each day. So do not lose your hand with Jesus. Never let go of Jesus. And you will be there one day. Probably we can say you are already there if you believe it. Thanks be to God. I will continue this invitation until the end of the month for us to celebrate. I hope we all can say, I'm a disciple. Thank you.
Timothy, chapter 2, verses 8 to 15. Timothy is being encouraged in his faith, urged to continue to preach the word of God as he received it from Paul, and to not give in to people who might want him to change the message or water down the message. In spite of any opposition he may find, he is encouraged to stay true to the message of his kingdom. Writes, remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, ascended of David. That is my gospel, for which I suffer hardship, even to the point of being chained like a criminal. But the word of God is not changed. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, so that they may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus
with eternal glory. This saying is sure. If we have died with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we deny him, he will also deny us. If we are faithless, he remains faithful. He cannot deny himself. Remind them of this and warn them before the Lord that they are to avoid wrangling over words, which does no good, but only ruins those who are listening. Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved by him, a worker who has no need to be ashamed, rightly explaining the word of truth. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. The gospel of the Lord this morning is taken from Luke chapter 17, verse 11 through 19. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 men with skin disease approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go show yourself to the priest." And they went. As they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? So where are the other 9? Did none of them return to give glory to God except this foreigner?" Then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Sleeping in the dream.
See everything, even though we do not understand all things, we know that we are living in God. As we do that, we know God is good.
Daytime, my life in Korea is nighttime. Together, we are God's care. Thank you very much for your prayers and thoughts. I realize it can be good. And I'm the last person to call the doctor. But when I realize there's no way that I can do to make it better, all that I do will only make it worse, what can you do? You call the doctor. So I called the doctor and I told her about it and I heard what she says to me. And I hung up the phone. And I immediately felt better, even before I took her medication. It is something that we are unsure, unknown, that we are not very comfortable. We're living in a world that market is shrinking. If you have money in the market, you are losing it. You're supposed to make more money, but it's not happening. But don't panic. If you want to make money, ask a lot of people who know how to make the money. They trust the market, right? Those who make a lot of money invest while people are scared of the market. They learn to trust even in times of market struggling. I know we are living in a world where there are a lot of rumors, storms, other things, scares us. Even probably remember hearing Armageddon last week. But sure thing that we shouldn't be worried about fear, about things that we cannot control. We can call unto the Lord. Come to the Lord and hear from the Lord. Some of you probably not sure of your pastor. Who is he? Stephanie said this morning, your mystery man. You probably wonder what he's thinking, what is he saying, what does it mean? He probably is thinking, what is he going? Where is he going? The real problem is, I do not know either. But I know when I'm in trouble, what to do. Call your doctor. Turn to the Lord. Open your ears, our heart, and listen. So here is the gospel today. We have 10 people who are in trouble. I should give them a big credit because they came to Jesus. There may be a lot more people in trouble, right? But 10 of them, they came to Jesus and cried for help. Guy like me, it's not easy to ask for help. So I should give them credit. They're keeping distance because they're not supposed to come closer to the people who are healthy and right, clean, considered. Jesus said to them, go. Show yourself to the priests. Which means that you get a certificate of proof of your cleanness. That's the way to do it. So everybody went away from Jesus and all on their way to get their certificate of cleanness, wellness, they found themselves all cleaned. Voila!
What a great joy they have. But they were away and they didn't come back to Jesus, and only one came to Jesus. I hear that he came not just thank him, he came praising God out loud, and he prostrate himself before Jesus. The symbolic act of prostration is about the nature of our faith. I'm nothing, but you are the master. I follow you. The priests, when they get ordained, they all prostrate themselves on the floor as a sign of submission, of their trust in the Lord. He was not just cured from disease or trouble, but also healed. But none others, they were cured, but not healed. The difference between this one person of the nine other person, they all experienced God's glory and the power of amazing greatness. That he knows that where that power came from and what this power can do, and recognize and praise God and grateful. He came back to Jesus. I guess you can be thankful and don't come back to Jesus, still you will be happy and thankful. But it's a symbolic act that you turn to Jesus, to prostrate yourself to Jesus, means something. It's an act of trust. We can be happy Sunday morning, but if we follow Jesus each and every day, every corner, every turn, and every crossroad, then we can be happy and praising and joyful, grateful all the time, even in times of trouble. How can we do that? Simple. We heard today. Just follow. And Jesus came to us to welcome us and tell us the good story and the gospel and to heal us and bless us. That would be Christ's joy for all to that. And that would be my goal as a pastor, to help you to be like Jesus. Sunday morning, all day, all night. So we can be happy, celebrating joyful Church of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. We have some prayer requests for especially Conchera. And there was a thing that we don't want to have, but it happened all the time, car accidents. The father and two other family members had been in the car accident, and they survived, and they're on the healing, on the way of healing, but their trauma, it'll take a while for them to come back, full back to life. So our prayers with Conchita and family. The car has been totally destroyed, but we think that they survived and through bones and injuries. It can happen to any time, anybody, and that is why it is so touching and scary for all of us. And I'll continue to pray for Noah Blanchett, who is serving U.S. Army Air Force in Kuwait. We have David Carmen, as he continue to make progress, and we have for Patty and Debbie and healing. Confirmation class. We have a small confirmation class, but it is a very exciting place to be. Get to know each other and get to know God. So continue to pray for our confirmation class. And feel free to come and join us if anybody wants to know their Bible, and we'll welcome. And pray for Uncle Bill, who is in intensive care in the hospital. Ellen Schneider, friend of also in the ICU. Therefore, Andrew Tony is going through a difficult time. Wendy Calabrese had shoulder surgery for torn muscles. Dear Lord, we thank you for this beautiful day of fellowship of your people. We came because you have called us, invited us to celebrate our life. And as we increase our joy, also we go out and to serve others. Thank you for blessing us, our body of fellowship, that we continue to come and worship you and serve one another. Thank you, Lord, for each and every one of members of this body. And we pray that some of us struggling and suffering from injury, from the brokenness, body, from the treatment, continue to struggle to make living each and every day for the better. Lord, strengthen us and touch us. Fill us with your spirit. with the power of grace that can touch and heal, as we have seen today's gospel. Lord, continue to be with us as we are making our journey through this year, through this fall time, busy time of the year. May we continue to be your faithful servant in this place for another 100 years, as we are happy and joyful to be thankful for your grace, which is you have blessed plenty. Receive our gratitude, O God, and thanks unto your grace. And may we continue to be praising God and serving others. We lift our heart unto you, God. Offer our thanks and praise, our heart of prayer for one another. And we pray all this with the prayer that you have taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Let us continue our worship as we bring our Sunday morning offering. To us, enjoy our friendship and fellowship with us, and made us one with you, and made us one with one another. Receive these offerings of our heart and bless us, and so we can celebrate our life as we share with one another our joy and our gratitude in this world. Bless our church and our journey from this day and forward. In his holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
of closing in and stand by me while me and holding me when I'm weak and walk with me all day long. So let us go with the Lord and celebrate our life. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. Amen.